Hello, my name is Linda Irish Bostic, and I'm the head coach of Palm Beach Masters. Today, with the help of two-time Olympic gold medalist Brian Goodell, we're going to talk about how to swim freestyle properly. Good breathing technique is much more challenging in freestyle than in the other strokes because your head is always underwater, except when you breathe to the side very near the surface. When you rotate to breathe, your head should rotate with your body at the same time. The recovery you use, or the way you get your arms from the finished position back to the catch position, should be what's relaxed, comfortable, and natural for you. Some swimmers use a classic high elbow, some use a straight arm recovery. You can choose from a range of head positions as you swim, depending on your individual needs. Something that works for one swimmer won't necessarily work for another. It's most important to focus on having a high body position in the water. Your chest, hips, legs, and feet should all be in one horizontal line near the surface. A good kicking technique is driven from your hips, not your knees. Your knees should be loose and relaxed and bend slightly. You should use a flutter kick to keep your legs high in the water. A six-beat kick, or taking six kicks for every two freestyle strokes, is ideal to generate the most propulsion. Body rotation, sometimes simply called body roll, is the rotation of the swimmer along the long axis of his or her spine as he or she swims. You should rotate between 45 and 60 degrees on every stroke you take, not just when you breathe. This helps you use the large muscle groups of your core, back, and chest to help drive your strokes versus just the small, weak shoulder muscles. Your hand should enter the water at a slightly downward angle with your palm facing towards the water's surface. Your hand should enter cleanly and enter before your elbow. As your hand enters the water and extends forward, it should be perfectly in line with your shoulder. Proper entry sets you up for a good catch. The catch is initiated with a tipping of your wrist. Your elbow bends and your forearm becomes more vertical in the water. A key to a great catch and pull is to feel the water during the catch phase and to engage with it by pressing it backwards, not pushing down on the water or to the side. Your hand shouldn't cross the center line of your body or move outside elbow width. When your hand is under your head, you enter the pull or power phase. Your hand and forearm are now facing directly backwards. As your hand moves towards the end of the stroke, your palm should be kept facing backward. At the end of your push, turn your hand slightly inward toward your thigh to finish your stroke as your hip on that side rotates upward. Your arm should exit the water once it has extended to around 150 degrees of elbow bend. Note, your arms shouldn't be fully extended with your elbow locked out when you finish your stroke. A common question I receive from swimmers about the catch phase of the stroke is how they hold their fingers, cupped or spread apart. Hold your fingers slightly apart where they are naturally relaxed. Don't tightly cup your fingers together and don't force your fingers far apart. Master these elements of your freestyle and you'll be able to master freestyle. Once again, I'm Linda Irish Bostic, head coach of Palm Beach Masters. Thank you for watching.